Hi, my loves. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Jessica Alexandria of Bahati Life. Thank you so much for tuning in. Today, we are doing your monthly forecast for the month of April for Virgos. And the cards that it is I pulled for you are Justice. Oh my gosh, I am myself a Virgo, and I keep seeing the Justice card. The Page of Swords and the Three of Pentacles from the Mini Rider-Waite. From Nature Oracle, we have Fog and Mist, Be Cautious. Now I can already see my Virgo starting to freak out. And Aspen, Shed the Old. And then from the Goddess Oracle deck, we see the card of Mother Earth. Now that's some powerful stuff that's been going on. I'm a Virgo, so I'm seeing a few trends going on here. So it's interesting that these trends are repeating and continuing to bleed into these readings. Let me see if I can adjust this so that you can see what it is that I'm seeing. But the first thing that I want to focus on, and I have to focus on this, is the Justice card, because this card has been showing up left and right for me, but also for, I've been seeing it a lot on the internet and in other readings. And the thing is with Justice is that, yeah, things need to be balanced and things need to be fair and equal and law and order. But more than that, when we're working with the Justice card and we're seeing this card, it really does want to talk about the balance of the universe. And I don't know why, but the word mercy is coming through, mercy and forgiveness. And then that makes me want to lead to this next card, which is Fog and Mist, which shows, you know, how you see things is not actually what they are. Virgos tend to have this way of looking at life that we can see every detail. And I say we, because again, I'm a Virgo. We can see every detail and we look for all of the details, but just because we see all doesn't mean that we're seeing all. Do you know what I mean? Because not everything, as much information or as much as we can put effort into trying to understand why something happened or getting all of the pieces of information, sometimes there's some things that it is that we don't see or that we don't miss, or maybe it's through a lens. And that's ultimately what it is that I'm seeing here with the Fog and Mist card, is that how can you see everything outside of the fact that you're human, but there's some aspects that, you know, you maybe your experiences kind of put a lens over you, or maybe your need to be cautious and your need to be protective of yourself, which makes sense, but it can block opportunity, can block you from seeing things or seeing people for who it is that they really are, because all you're seeing is, you know, from your perspective only. Now, I do want to give credit to Virgo, or to you, for everything that it is that you've experienced and your need to be cautious. That is there in order to protect yourself. But there's so much of this that's in the mind, and that's what it is that I'm seeing while I'm looking at these cards. And the intuitive message is you're trying to process, you're trying to approach things from such a logical perspective. And the reality is that it's probably, at least for the month of April, just try and move from your heart and maybe don't second guess and triple guess yourself or cut something off or cut someone out because, you know, it may not, you know, the pieces don't add up. In fact, I actually see you needing to connect with others instead of you being self-sufficient and doing things for yourself all by yourself, because no one can do it like Virgo can, and I know this because I'm a Virgo. There's actually a need for you to connect with others and to rely on others, because they may not do it the same way you do it, but just because they're not doing it the same way doesn't mean that they are not doing it an excellent way. And I really want you to be open to that. And that this is why this grounding card seems to be here, at least from what it is that I'm feeling and what I'm sensing, is instead of it being all in your mind and so, you know, what makes sense to you and what, you know, make, like, what logically is the right conclusion, then the right next step, ground yourself and center yourself, connect with Earth, connect with manifestation, connect with the divine through the earth, through grounding yourself. And earth is, or Virgo is an earth sign. So this is how we ground ourselves. So connect with the earth in order to, you know, again, center yourself before you completely cut things out and say no. Now back to the Justice card. For those of you guys that don't know how I work tarot and how I work with the tarot, I see the symbols on the card and it triggers my intuition. That's something that it is that I teach within the Sacred Circle Tarot School. It's a class, for those of you guys that don't know, it's a school that I hold, an online virtual school that I hold to teach people how to work with the tarot. Through their intuition. Yes, I work with the definition of the card and the traditional meaning of the card, but the tarot is just a tool for your intuition and for your gifts and for the divine and spirit to work through in order to deliver a message that it is that you need to receive. And the major words that it is that I'm feeling with this is mercy, forgiveness, and staying open. And now that moves me on to, and I just want to move this aside, now that moves me on to shedding the old, Justice, Page of Swords, and the Three of Pentacles. So I think what I want to say, Virgos, is that the universe works with energy and it wants to always balance itself out, like life and death, light and dark, growing and dormant, you know, still and movement. Like it's always working with these balancing balancing vibrations. So what has been put out there and what has happened is what is going to be received. And what you have received is what you might have been given. Or if you're not receiving enough, then you need to make that decision again to, after you ground yourself and center yourself, that maybe you pull back. Maybe you don't do as much. Maybe you have been pulled back. Maybe you have been cautious. Maybe you've been overly cautious and another person has been approaching and trying to connect with you, because I do see this element of connection. But because you are so, you know, have this veil over your eyes and that you can't see the good, you're only focusing on the negative, it's making you say no, it's making you push away. And it's all well and good in order to be, again, guarded and protective of yourself because of everything that it is that has happened in the past, but it can't stop how you see the future and it can't stop how you see potential for yourself for the future. Now, again, if you, what I really want is, yeah, let me take a moment and say this, that the universe, because it works with balances, let the universe sort everything out. I don't want you, and I know as Virgos, trust me, I know how hard it is to receive this message because I can be a micromanager, I am a perfectionist, and I'm very protective, and I pay attention to detail, so I know how hard that is. But, and I don't want you to kind of sort through everything. I want you to step back, to let go, and I want you to allow the universe to kind of restore balance, and it all by itself. So if you have put energy out, then it's time for you to receive, but I don't want you to create like an invoice and be like, okay, this is what you owe me. Or let's say that you have been, you know, receiving, or and someone's showing and trying to connect with you, trying to connect with you, then open your hands up and receive it and then give back, because that's balance. When you do that, you will get more. The other thing that I'm seeing is it's time for you right now for the month of April to really focus on releasing any harboring hurt or suffering, things that you have done in the past that you might regret, things that others have done to you that has hurt you. Now, when you give forgiveness, you're not saying simultaneously that you accept the behavior and that you're okay with the behavior. What you are doing is you are releasing yourself from the burden, from the heaviness, from the resentment, from the guilt of carrying what has happened to you in the past. And when that happens, you can then finally see things clearer for yourself and make better decisions for yourself. Let the universe handle things out. Let the universe deal out karma. But what I want you to do is to really release, to let go, to have mercy, and to forgive in order for you to move forward so that this energy, this fog, starts to lift so that it doesn't bog you down. That's what it is that I'm seeing this fog as. I'm seeing it as this cloud, this lens that is that you're looking through with things. Maybe, potentially, you can ask the universe, okay, why did this happen, or why did this person do this? Show me their perspective. Maybe call out to the universe and tell the universe, like, I need to know why this happened to me, or I need to understand why it is that I did this, or why these things happened. But after that, let it go, release it, ground, and let the universe and let this month kind of sort itself out. Before, I just don't think that, you know, as And I'm a Virgo, so I have to like listen to my own advice, but I'm just gonna release my need to control things and maybe not call the shots so much and allow, you know, things to kind of restore the balance for themselves. That's ultimately what it is I see. And the best thing to do is to ground yourself, to restore your energy, to fill your cup, fill your body with nourishing foods, go out, get fresh air, you know, go for walks, go for bike rides. That's what I've been doing. It's really been helping me. And yeah, just being a human again, being just an imperfect but perfect being. All right, so I hope that message makes sense. If it did, give me a thumbs up, or if you love this video, give me a thumbs up. Make sure that you're subscribed and you have your notifications turned on so that you can get more videos just like this one. And I will see you in my next video. Bye.